Hello, everyone, and welcome. It's the 90s. It's time for old games. I'm Jeff. I'm joined on the couch up front here by Brad and Matt Rorie.
Find the camera. Find the camera.
I don't know. That one.
I can't look at the cameras.
Hey, man. Just go across like that, and it's just
throwing
like,
us a fastball
it's
there.
Here, and then it's. You know?
Sure. No.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
So
it's the 90s, huh?
Oh, Jesus. So we want to get together on a semi-regular basis here to take a look at some old-ass games. This isn't about, we're going to have expert this and that. It's, you know, we want to look at some of this stuff and see some of the deeper parts of these games. So we're kind of digging in a little bit, cheating our way through some stuff just to get a look at, the graphics, some of the soundtrack stuff.
And more like a museum piece.
Yeah, get a feel for... or kind of what this stuff was. There's a lot of stuff that I remember playing that's just like, was this game actually any good or not? And that brings us to the first game here, which we teased a little bit last week. Thunder Force 3 for the Sega Genesis.
Now hang on. You said you want to find out if this game was actually any good or not.
This game is probably pretty cool.
Okay.
But I
thought your feelings on Thunder Force 3 were quite clear.
I remember
last
thinking
week.
This game is rad.
Yeah.
This level in particular, we talked a little bit about last week, being like, it's one of those things that like you saw screenshots in magazines of just like, look at this incredible cartridge, holy shit, and it kind of became something that at the time, like visually, it was something you really wanted to see. Running for yourself.
Yeah, there's definitely a mystique around this game.
Yeah, because like Thunder Force 2 is a top-down game. It's a cool game.
Yeah.
It's kind of a different thing. So I'm going to just get in here and start playing. Again, we're getting our cheat on here, so I'm going to start with pretty much all the weapons. Level select here, pick from any one of these five.
You start with the weapons? Can you cycle through them?
With the weapons and you can cycle through them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. When you die, you would lose weapon power and upgrades and stuff like that. We're kind of sidestepping that sort of stuff just to kind of devastate.
Good lord.
Our way through the game.
There's some tinny weapon sounds.
Good lord. It's a significant amount of firepower.
Yeah, you shoot well. This is the default weapon powered all the way up,
How many levels of upgrade is it? Three? It's like the little triangles on the top right.
No. The triangles on the top right are actually my movement speed.
Oh,
there
right,
were a lot of Genesis games,
that.
So I can hit A to kind of move between these four different speed levels of movement and kind of just what you're comfortable with, or areas that require some more precision movement. You can slow down a little bit so that you're not just immediately crashing into walls and stuff like that.
What is the storyline here?
I'm a ship. I gotta shoot stuff. That's a great question.
Actually. Aliens, dude. They must die.
Technically, you're the alien if you're going to other planets. Not the enemy, and he is us.
Whoa.
This was a. Mega Drive Genesis game first, then it was an arcade game.
Yeah.
It became an arcade game later.
Huh. Yeah, they put it out in arcades. It was so kind of well received, I guess. That version's pretty similar to this one, all told.
The setting of Thunder Force 3, you'll want to notice, takes place about 100 years after Thunder Force and directly after Thunder Force 2.
Good to know.
Okay. That makes sense.
It makes so much more sense.
The Galaxy Federation has not been faring well in their battle against the Orn Empire. Cloaking devices on five major planets in their space territory that conceal their main base. Blah, blah, blah. Remote defense system. Blah, 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 blah. The biocomputer Cha-Os. Chaos. I don't know what any of this means.
You mean chaos?
You are piloting sticks. Is that correct?
Sure. Yeah. I mean, is
apparently.
That the, you mean like the name of the ship?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, the story is not necessarily conveyed in the game.
Sorry. The Fire Leo-03 sticks.
Are you speaking English?
I believe I am.
What?
Emergency. There. That's
there.
The story. You know what the story of this game is? This fucking dragon.
Giant.
Is trying to murder me.
I don't think fire works that way.
It's a cyborg dinosaur.
I really like the look of the little, like, with the hits, these little ovals.
Yeah.
So this is means I'm kind of doing no damage, and then you get down here, it'll change color, and that means, hey, you're doing proper damage.
Weak point stomach.
Yeah, weak
I
point
saw that.
Stomach.
I saw that in the mission briefing.
Apparently the weak point worked.
That was,
I mean,
kind
of short work.
Like,
that
melted
thing
through the ground?
Yeah. And I guess it's conceivable, since you can select any level to start with, you could go into any of these levels with all these weapons.
I was going to say, like, there's no prescribed order whatsoever, right?
Yeah, it's just, you know, as soon as you... I mean, I think that is tradition. That's the level that it starts, the cursor starts on.
Okay.
So I've always thought of that as the first level.
So that's basically the Airman.
Sure.
So this game's Mega Man 2.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, Mega Man 2, that's a good old game.
Yeah! Yes.
I mean, you know, not to...
I've been having a lot of thoughts about Mega Man lately in terms of just, like, I'm not so sure that I want to go back to those games.
Ooh, I don't know that I'm ready. These are dangerous thoughts that you're having.
Yeah!
I don't know if I'm ready to entertain any, some of these ideas. I don't know. I saw some footage of Mighty No. 9 the other day, and I was kind of looking at that going, like, huh. I don't know if this is something I'm looking for.
Well, Axiom Verge, everybody's been raving over.
So. Yeah, but that's a very different kind of game. Mega Man is very much like run to the right and occasionally climb ladders up and then fight a boss.
Has Mighty No. 9 still not come out?
Yeah, I think they're getting there, because this footage I saw looked pretty final. I don't know, it looked all right.
We'll know more at E3.
Possibly. Will we?
Is anyone publishing it? Because it wouldn't necessarily be there on its own. That seems like the sort of game, if it's coming out on like a console platform, then the console holder will be like, hey, we'll give you a kiosk.
Right.
So that'll probably be there somewhere,
Some
actually.
Some poor soul left stand there 8 hours a day.
Oh, there's an extra life down there, but, oh. Whew.
Are you dying?
No,
you,
I mean, no.
Okay.
I can die. I didn't cheat my way into invincibility.
Well, I don't think we got into it too much last week, but, like, what kind of capability do you have here, cheat-wise?
It's basically, like, action replay-style codes. A lot of the stuff will take Game Genie codes as well.
But then can you toggle those on and off in real time, or...?
Yeah, I can. Well, I can go into a menu and kind of adjust what's active and what's not.
So you don't have, like, a key that just gives you more lives or anything like that?
No.
Somebody in the chat wanted to know, Sharp1011, what is the best Mega Man? Generally, the consensus is Mega Man 2.
I mean, I would have said 2, even though, I mean, I don't know, like...
2 or 3, I don't know.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's one of those weird situations where 3 has more.
Yeah.
Like, there's just more 2, 3, you know, with Rush. And some of the... They have the slide in 3.
That sounds
they
right.
They did. I think the slide was new in 3. Like, there's more mechanics, but...
Was there a Mega Man cartoon?
Mega Man was on Captain N.
Yeah, that's the only one I can think of.
I'm gonna talk like this.
Yeah.
Actually, I don't know if that's exactly how he sounded, but he had a weird gruff voice.
That is exactly how he sounded.
Is that?
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, hey, it's me, I'm Mega Man.
Yeah, it's just real crappy.
Check out my Mega Buster.
So we went from a crazy solar flare, crazy fire planet, to now we're underwater. You can tell by the bubbles, you see. We're underwater.
Of course.
How is your ship so good at moving underwater? It feels like it'd be slowed down by...
Dude, he's part of the... It's being raised up by the bubbles there, so... Oh, okay.
Also, he's part of the Thunder Force.
Yeah, also...
Think about it.
Is there thunder underwater? I don't think there is.
It doesn't matter.
I guess thunder is more of a sound than a... I don't know.
Remember what I said to think about it? I'm taking it back.
There's apparently been a couple of thunderstorms here late at night, but I haven't heard any really good thunder.
Yeah, yesterday up where I live, there was quite a bit of thunder in the afternoon, and I was bummed out that I was not there.
Yeah.
We got some rain 2 days in a row.
Yeah, like barely any.
Guess what? Yeah. Drought's over.
All right, cool. Yeah. I'm going to go flush my toilet 1,000 times.
Yeah, start watering your lawn and washing the car again.
Well, all that stuff doesn't matter.
I know,
apparently 10% of all water in California is taken up by almond farmers.
Yeah, no, almonds are hugely water-dependent crops. Also, I guess California grows something like 80% of the world's almonds.
Yeah, that's why the water restrictions are really tough to... You can't really ask farmers to cut... Well, you can, but a lot of people love almonds, wouldn't begin them.
A lot of produce is going to get more expensive in the near future.
Yeah, well, the cost for water should be baked into the produce. It shouldn't be subsidized, yeah. I mean.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, like if...
Nobody's talking about taxing, just making a realistic assessment of what water costs in California now.
Yeah.
I feel like there is no surer sign that we are moving into the cyberpunk dystopia than that water is now like a sought after, like, people are gonna be fighting over water soon, right?
I already do. You know, Nestle had that whole stuff where they tried to tell people rainwater.
Yeah, but I mean, like, them. I mean, like actual, like, water wars.
We're water world.
Yeah, we're gonna go blow up a Nestle facility and
take hopefully, their water. Hopefully, somebody will make some really efficient desalinization technology at some point. That'll be kind of a holy grail for any company that can do it.
You know, I used to be better at these sorts of games. I kind of let myself slip. You know, it's one of those things where you're tempted to say, like, oh, well, I'm old. But, like, it's... I just haven't stuck with these types of shooters as they became more bullet hellish.
Sure.
And more specialized and stuff like that. I kind of just, oh, the G-Lobster.
Target G-Lobster.
It's the G-ass lobster we're coming up on here.
You said the...
Oh, that's
whoa,
bad.
That's...
Yeah, you gotta get through there.
I thought that thing was gonna go back down.
Nope.
Like you would have an interval to get through that thing, but nope. It's just like you didn't make it, you're fucked. You mentioned that the previous game was a top down
shooter. And kind of multi directional, like almost like I hesitate to say open world, but like
Where do you fall traditionally on the top-down versus side-scrolling split?
I like side-scrolling shooters better than top-down scrolling shooters.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Thunder Force lets you kind of move in any direction, like Bosconian or something like that.
Okay.
So it's sort of
different. Oh, that's a pretty different kind of game.
Oh, that's weird.
I was totally on the side-scrolling train.
Yeah.
I never really got into Raiden and stuff like that very much. Or even
same here, yeah.
Even like 1942.
I played a lot of 1942 just because... You know, I got it as a gift for the NES and ended up playing that a lot and kind of got into 43 as a result. But that was kind of about it. You know what games kick ass? UN Squadron.
Yes! Fuck. I would play UN Squadron right now if you put it in front of me.
Well, we will have to consider that down the line then.
Wasn't there something... I remember there being like something severely lacking about the Super NES version of UN Squadron.
Was it maybe a one-player only game?
I think that's what it was. I think it did not have the two-player.
You chose poorly.
Yeah, that's... Wait, hang on.
What?
Nope.
What the...
You're falling backwards.
Good thing I've got this back shot.
Really, it's really flipping the script on you.
Yeah.
I played a significant amount of UN Squadron in the, like, lobby area of a Walmart.
See, I've only really played it on the... SNES.
Oh, really? So. Oh, yeah, no, they had UN Squadron at the opening of our local Walmart, and I would just stay there while my mom was in Walmart.
I've never played a lot of arcade games in this kind of era.
Really?
What was it, like, 91?
This is 90. 90.
Yeah, this was, yes.
I mean, I played, I lived in the suburbs, basically the only play when you went to the movies, because they always had good,
You didn't have a good local mall arcade?
We might have, I don't remember.
We had an amazing arcade, like, for the... Podunk-ass little town I lived in, I didn't realize how good our arcade was.
Chuck E. Cheese and stuff like that, you know?
Yeah.
The Chuck E. Cheese that I had access to kind of in the, you know, mid-80s, early 80s was pretty awesome.
Once Virtua Fighter and Virtua Fighter 2 came out for my Saturn, I want to say, the appeal of going to an arcade and plunking, because that's mostly what I like playing was a shooter.
Of course, at that point.
Light games.
At that point, home consoles were starting to beat the shit out of arcades.
Man, I want to play Virtua Fighter 2 again, or Virtua Cop 2 again. Say Virtua Cop? Did I say Virtua Cop the first time?
You said Virtua Fighter the first
time.
No,
I meant Virtua Cop.
Oh, okay. Said you were into shooters, and I got really confused.
Yeah, whatever brand of genre that is. But
I understand there are ways to play Virtua Cop.
Virtua Cop is great.
Yeah, there's a Saturn version of Virtua Cop and Virtua Cop 2, right?
Yeah, I believe so. I don't think they ever... Virtua Cop 2, I think, was the last one they made. It kind of went to
3, I thought. It was like a Model 3 game or something.
Maybe it was only arcades. I don't know if they ever came out for...
What if Sega announced a new Virtua Cop at
E3? Yeah.
It's like, fuck it, we're making a new one.
Well, the arcade stuff, if you go to a theater now, there's almost no new arcade machines.
Yeah, I mean, it's not
there's like, you know, like that Fast and the Furious motorcycle game.
Yeah,
there's just not many games.
It's not a great driving game. It's not a, you know, there's just...
That weird Terminator... Light gun game.
Right. They're like, hey man, Midway made a good one of these a long time ago. What if we tried to make another one? And
dude,
like, nope. Turns out they were better at making games than we were.
Just iced the G-Lobster.
Yeah, the G Lobster.
Like
could not
handily
withstand.
In seconds.
Right, the mobile fort is up next.
That sounds more formidable.
Stage Ellis.
Ellis.
Now, if anybody has questions about Thunder Force or Thunder Force 2 or 3, please.
Or California's ongoing drought.
Yes, just if you got questions, send them to Matt Rorie. We'll take questions. Yeah, we're hanging out.
I'm not going to know any answers, but maybe Jeff will. May happen.
And then Thunder Force 4 was kind of just a sequel to this game.
Oh, I didn't know they made a fourth.
Yeah, it's pretty much.
Also Genesis?
Yeah. Hmm.
The scrolling in the background looks like a Final Fantasy map.
You're right, yeah. I want to say that there was a Thunder Force for the Saturn that was not great.
Huh.
I could be making that up.
We gotta bust out the Saturn sometime. Do a stream for it.
Yeah, I don't know that we've done a ton with the Saturn ever. Have we?
I brought my Saturn in at one point. I think we
did something on UPF one time.
Yeah.
I won a Saturn through a Fox Kids postcard contest when it was like $400. It's one of the sweetest moments of my life. Came with Virtua Fighter Remix.
And then you got it and you were like, oh.
No, I love that. I love that console. Dragon Force.
Kidding.
Virtua Fighter 2. I still have a bunch of games for that.
I feel like I remember being like a little disappointed with it like at launch, but like yeah, by the time like BF2, some of that other stuff was coming out, like the Saturn really kind of
It launched at such a price point that it didn't really have much of a chance.
Yeah, because I picked it up and was like, all right, Clockwork Knight, here we go.
Yeah, that was
the
big thing.
I can't stand that game.
That was like kind of the big game, right?
Daytona was the big game.
Oh, did that ship at launch?
Yeah, and then I remember getting. Like I had Daytona, Virtua Fighter, pre-VF Remix, so it was the one that sucked in a way that they were like, well, we should probably make a new one of these, and they made VF Remix because it was so poorly received. And then Street Fighter the movie.
Yes. God, I didn't realize that even came out on the Saturn.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a weird game.
We can play it sometime. Yeah. Anytime you want, I'm ready.
Yeah, I mean, that's a weird game because it's a port of an arcade game, but it's totally different from the arcade.
Oh,
game.
That came out in the arcade?
Yeah, weird. It was originally an arcade game, and, Incredible Technologies did it, and, it played differently in arcades. There were things about it that didn't feel like Street Fighter.
Huh.
And when they brought it home to PlayStation and Saturn, they said, fuck it, and made it like Street Fighter. There was just I'm trying to think. It was timing stuff. There were some moves. I want to say that they changed the properties of.
I want to see that stuff. That sounds ridiculous. Is this where we find out that Jason is secretly a god tier Street Fighter the movie player?
You have no idea, Brad.
Which version, though? I mean, come on, what home version?
Oh, the home version. Yeah, okay, all right. Mostly Street Fighter, but I've dabbled in the arcade versions as well. I used to play that pretty hardcore in the arcade.
Wow. Can you do you know what the differences are? Can you enlighten me on the differences? I'm forgetting.
Yeah, me too. Sorry.
Okay. All right, now we've beaten all the basic stages, and now we're after Cerberus. So this is just a big Mass Effect ripoff, apparently.
I was trying to think of some kind of Cerberus joke and coming up with nothing.
Thunder Force 6 came out for the PlayStation 2 in 2008. Looks like it was Japan only, says Automatic Toast.
Yeah, that stuff kind of stopped coming out. This stuff kind of stopped coming out over here.
I was going to say, we looked up Technosoft last week, and they had gotten acquired by whoever and, folded into R&D or whatever. But I was wondering what happened between this and then that acquisition. You know, they had to keep making games.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't realize they just weren't getting out of Japan anymore.
I mean, there was a lot of stuff that, there's a lot of stuff from that era that definitely didn't make it out of Japan, you know? I think people kind of soured on this style of game kind of until everyone started understanding the bullet hell concept. And no, we're just going to make them super hard.
Right.
And the hitbox on your ship's tiny, and it's going to be a very different thing that, a smaller segment of the audience will still really appreciate. And that's how they kind of modernized it, I guess, right? There are no just, base level... generic, this game was not that difficult. I could finish this game.
Right. Your life forces and stuff were doable.
Yeah.
I remember beating that game.
And then when stuff got super crazy, it just became is this just designed to suck quarters, or what's really going on here?
I mean, I mentioned them before, but R-Type Delta and Einhander
Right.
Were two,
yeah,
like,
those are,
for a
those
while,
are...
those came out, and I was like, oh, man, like 2D gameplay, 3D graphics shooters are going to be amazing, and then they just didn't make any more of them.
Yeah.
But I thought those two games are fantastic.
All right, blowing up this gigantic ship. It's going well, I'd say.
I homebrewed my PSP just to play those games on it. Back when it, you know, you could convert any, take any actual PlayStation disc and turn it into a PSP game.
Yeah.
And just put those games on there. Kind of awesome.
Still with them to bring out Metal Gear Acid. Maybe I'm gonna go back and hook up my PSP at some point. Metal Gear Acid 2 again. I like that game a lot.
Well, they have some PSP games on.
They do. Vita, but they,
not that one.
They never put that out. Maybe it's some licensing issue. There's a Konami game, and I don't know. But Metal Gear Acid, they're great. They're great.
Both of them? You like both of them?
I did like both of them quite a bit. Metal Gear Acid 1 had some bad frame rate problems, but Metal Gear Acid 2 was definitely a one to play. I mean, it had like twice as many cards in it. And and they're both super fucking crazy storylines and everything. So.
Cards.
Orn base.
All right.
This is going to be our final level, I guess.
Yeah, that's probably where the stuff happens.
And then Acid 2 was the one that, like, looked awesome.
Yeah,
right?
It was all,
yeah,
like,
cel-shaded. And
cel-shaded.
Had the 3D goggles that came with it.
Oh, right.
You could strap on your PSP,
right.
Which tried once and then never used again.
I totally forgot about that.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't just cel-shaded, though. Like, the color palette was super crazy, like, neon, wasn't it? Like,
it was really
everything
pink.
Was, like, everything was, like, pink and yellow pastel.
Yeah, it was crazy. It was really, really fun.
It was a weird game.
Did that have the stuff that, like, Portable Ops had, where you'd go to a Wi-Fi access point and use that to get stuff?
I have no idea. I never played Portable Ops.
I'm dead. That door just came down, and it's like, nope, fuck you. You should have thought of that.
I mean, that's the value of a door, you know? Once you close it, you can keep it closed.
Yeah.
And then nobody can get through.
Right.
Well, so Portable Ops was the first PSP game, and Ghost Walker was the second, or Peace Walker?
No, Peace Walker was the last one.
Peace Walker that had the Wi-Fi stuff. But it was like it would key off of, like, whatever the MAC address of the Wi-Fi point was, and you would get characters based on that stuff. So people started spoofing their MACs to get... like specific characters and all sorts of other shit.
I never finished any of those 3D Metal Gear games.
Yeah.
The controls are just so tough to deal with.
Yeah, those games play poorly enough on consoles.
I just couldn't look around corners, it was so hard. Mm.
I'm just gonna finish this game.
Yeah, that's cool. I mean, you know, we're kind of in it for the long haul at this point.
Yeah.
Jeff, you ever play Wings of War / Ginoog?
Yeah.
Any good?
I remember liking it. I remember, like, part of it looking cool.
Racking my brain, trying to remember what that is.
It's a shooter like this, but it's like you're a... what are you? You're like,
oh, jeez.
Are you a gargoyle in that game?
You're not like an angel, are you?
Maybe that's...
Or am I thinking of Legendary Wings?
I mean, that... that may also be the case, but I think you are some sort of winged creature in that game. I was thinking, like, at some point we should play, like, Gyarus and, like, Arrow Flash and some of the other 16-bit shooters.
Try to think of other scrolling shooters where you're, like, a dude and not a ship.
Damn it. Forgotten Worlds.
Yeah, okay.
I love Forgotten Worlds. That's so good.
I don't know if I ever... was it Genesis or... was it...
it was arcade and Genesis.
Okay.
Capcom. It had a rotating joystick.
Oh, right. That game was the Genesis of the term Zenny, right?
Yep.
Get it, Genesis, right? Yeah, okay.
I couldn't tell you with certainty that that is first game with Zenny, but it was the first one that I saw.
Sure. That's Section Z.
Section Z's cool, you can shoot in both directions.
Yeah. Is there, like, some kind of robotic bee man in that game?
Probably, yeah. That seems like something that would be in that game.
I used to rent every NES game I could get my hands on.
Yeah, me too.
So I've got experience with tons and tons of NES games for about, you know, 48 to 72 hours.
Yep. With a lot of these games, that's the exact right amount of experience to have.
$5 in 3 days, that was about all you needed.
One of these things. All right. These spheres that's shooting out that then burst into the... That's annoying. All right, moving on. I like to have these big readouts. Oh.
Brad, someone wants to know if you ever played the Escape Velocity games on the Mac.
I don't think so.
Good answer. It
sounds familiar.
They're like pretty old.
Oh, geez. Are they Mac only?
Yeah. Weird. Well, I want to say maybe one of the later ones did come to PC, but like at the time it was. I think people think of it as a Mac franchise.
Weird.
Like Spectre VR and.
Right.
Like video games on the Mac.
Right.
Yeah, best of luck with that one.
Right.
Like.
Marathons.
I was going to say, Marathon pretty much started and stopped with Marathon.
I remember.
Chaos.
There we go.
The Orn Core.
I remember when Bungie got bought by Microsoft. There were a lot of
tears. Oh my god, dude, the rage over that.
A lot of tears.
I mean, I was one of those people. Like, I, you know, was back
But
when,
not for the same reasons. Not for, well, so much for that time.
No. It was purely because they had put out a ton of pre-release footage of Halo, or what Halo was at that time.
Right.
And it looked fucking amazing.
They're held back by Apple.
Are you ready for Chaos?
Not especially.
Well, I called it Cha-os.
Cha-os.
I don't know. Now I see it. I see it now.
Like some kind of cybernetic tea.
Oh, jeez. That's fast.
A Chai-OS. My open source fair trade operating system. I'm awesome. I beat Thunder Force.
Yeah.
I'm pretty much the best in the world.
All right. Here we go.
All right. Now, what do we get?
It's an amazing ending. You win.
I can let the credits roll and then go make sure the wiki's up to date.
Somebody was asking what the first game was that had the options, like the little things that Richard earned a ship. Is that Gradius, maybe? Or
1942 would have tiny ships that would come up next to your ship as an upgrade.
Well, technically, wouldn't... what was that game we were playing last? Centipede or the shooter that what? You could let them steal your ship and you can get it back?
Oh, Galaga.
Galaga? Maybe that would be...
It's not quite
sort
the same
of a,
thing.
That's sort of a different thing, but...
I mean, Gradius was the first one. They called it an option, of course.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh.
Hey, man. No Mode 7 ship. You gotta fucking do what you can.
Yeah, that's fair.
No scaling, no rotation.
Jeff, you committed genocide. How do you feel about that? You killed the entire race.
I feel great.
What was that?
Out fucking
oh, I see.
Oh.
Alright, well, that problem's solved.
Yeah.
I showed you that video of that guy that ported F-Zero to the Genesis.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
I looked at it a little bit. Like, he did implement a full scaling and rotation solution in software for that thing.
That's neat.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Jeff, do you own a CPC-464? I don't know what that is.
No, I don't know that really had a release in the U.S. I'm not sure. Like, the Amstrad stuff, I just never encountered it, ever. In a flash, the planet of Orn disappeared completely.
Man. Nice.
Orn could no longer control the huge amount of energy that it accumulated after he lost his owner. Like some kinky sub-dom situation. The Emperor Orn. I've been disturbing the Union of Milky Way for a long time. What was his true character? It was a huge biocomputer that had been made at the beginning of the Space Age. Oh man, it was human tech that had turned on us or something, right? Besides, his computer brain was developing extraordinary. And he began to have his own will. He denied the existence of human beings. And he finally exercised a program to kill the whole human race. It was evidently human beings who had given him this idea, therefore human beings should think of the meaning deeply. Anyway, the war was over.
You know, it might have taken some genocide, but it's done.
Human beings, think about what you have done. Think about it!
Keeps on going. Okay.
So the base fellows turn over his airframe to the base fellows waiting for them. I've been promoted. I'm a base fellow. I'm pretty excited about it.
So I guess Styx is a proper name for the pilot. You might.
Gene and Shelly, you might aware of the real meaning of true peace.
Who? What?
Gene and Shelly.
Who?
Gene and Jean. Jean and. Jean and Shelly. True peace.
All right. Peace and justice and
somebody
whatever.
In the chat said they miss badly translated games, and
yeah,
I think that's
yeah.
good. They are fun.
I don't think you could get away with like in jokey, intentional poor translation these days though.
It's something that like one of the characters in Axiom Verge talk in broken English in a way that like occasionally evokes a bad localization.
Oh, I hadn't thought of it that way.
And I think they kind of, I don't know if that's intentional or not, but it's weird. Maybe this is Jean and Shelley here flying the sticks.
I want to see the names on this. Look at that dude in the back. Like, he's like, woo!
Oh, I'm going to be bummed if these credits just use all real names. Was this past the era where they were using
No, this was still, I mean, this is kind of, you know, you think about Street Fighter 2 had a lot of that stuff.
Right. And that was just like anti-headhunting, right?
In a lot of cases, yeah. That
like was they just didn't want other companies to know who their creative people
who
were.
Who their fucking aces were, yeah.
Back in the day before Jambo?
It's true.
Yeah, so it's like actually, like I spent a lot of time kind of trying to figure out like, okay, who is Yuhi Chan's papa? Who is Pooh?
Right.
Who is, you know, like all that sort of stuff.
Who is Mappy?
And attach it to the right person pages and aliases and stuff like that. A lot of people have done that legwork, which is why I was able to kind of find anything. But
right.
Look at that guy's mustache. Anime mustache.
It's kind of a shitty mustache.
Yeah.
He's also got the sort of sleazebag looking gray streaks.
Yeah. I think there you go, asshole. There's one.
There, okay, yeah. Also, what voice? Unless voice could mean, like, music?
There's a go when you pick up items or something. Right. I don't know. Wording. Who did the wording on this?
Technosoft handled all the produce.
Yeah.
So make sure, you know, there's like fresh.
So wash it. Make sure you wash
fresh
it.
Fresh apples and oranges in the break room every day.
And the photo got old and everyone in it was dead. But we'll always have those times when we murdered the weird biocomputer that was trying to murder us. The end. I like games that stick at this screen.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, you gotta reset it now if you want out. I'm gonna hit start. Okay.
Your game is over.
My game's over, and then it resets. So that is Thunder Force 3.
That is like the totality of Thunder Force 3.
Yeah.
I don't assume there's anything else.
I mean, there are hard, you know, there's like a harder difficulty you could set up, I believe, and kind of go through.
Anyway, the war is over.
You know, that route and stuff like that.
Never again will the G-Lobster threaten the safety of the galaxy.
Yeah.
Had it coming anyways.
It's true.
Yeah. All right, so it's time for the voting segment.
Okay. How about you set that up?
We've got a couple of new games I've got to set up back here. So
you have to get your poll stick this time.
I'm gonna pull the trigger on some voting here, so people in the chat get ready to vote for the next game. And
they'll probably vote by the time they hear this.
Yeah, that's why I'm kind of waiting here to click the button to create. See, I've got this. I'm thinking about this.
It's like they're traveling through time.
Okay, here we go. We're going to vote between Pinball Quest for the NES, Valis 3 for the Genesis, and Space Harrier, the arcade version.
Mm.
You know, humans, think about what you have done before you get too deep into the voting. You
know? I think I know what the odds-on favorite is, but I... Oh, that's... Wow.
That really... right. The poll is fluctuating here, but it seems like we've got a
that really
set direction here.
That definitely defied my expectations.
All right.
Somebody earlier wanted to know if you guys are going to do a quick look for a GTA 5 PC version.
I've been thinking about that. But we're getting to the point now where our office PCs are not really top of the line anymore. So I guess we need to see how they run, how it runs on those things.
They delayed those new Intel chips, the Skybridge, whatever. It's
Skylake.
Fucking Tober.
Did they really?
October or August or something like that.
Man,
they're going to put out a couple Broadwells.
I was going to get one of those.
Yeah. I feel like my computer's okay for now, but I really wanted to wait for the new gen.
I just hit the 5-year mark on my CPU.
Yeah, mine's like...
Yeah, my CPU is probably my weak point at this point. Like, I have a 980, I have 32 gigs of RAM.
Yeah, I have a 7-year-old CPU, I think. I mean, video cards are mostly what's important now, but
yeah, we
doing stuff like I can't watch 4K video on my 4K monitor because my computer can't handle it.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. I have a Sandy Bridge?
I believe that's the case. I think you went one generation after me.
Yeah.
If I remember.
Yeah, yeah.
transferring files takes a long time. I don't have USB 3.0 on
where, where are you getting 4K video from?
I know a guy.
Places. There's 4K video on YouTube.
Is that really?
Yeah, you can download the files and stuff like that. There's a bunch of like sample 4K videos anyways, but it just like chugs the processor.
All right, let's get into this second game. You voted it. This is your fault, Pinball Quest. You asked for it. Pinball Quest.
Now you're going to get it.
A Jalico joint straight out of, 1990. Same copyright year, actually, as Thunder Force 3, so think about that. I've got this set up, so I believe we'll be able to buy things out of the store for free.
Pop up!
So yeah, this is an NES joint, and they have three preset tables, and then RPG mode was kind of the thing about this game. And I remember renting this game multiple times and putting a lot of time into it, getting a hold of a copy, and never really finishing it, but thinking it was just an awesome idea. This whole like concept of like, hey, let's take a pinball thing and make a like an RPG out of it. So
this is
monsters
totally
roll up in here and fuck up these pinballs, steal the pinball queen or something.
This is back in the day when the saves were on the cartridge instead of your machine.
This didn't even have saves.
Oh really?
I don't think.
Well, I remember going back and renting some stuff and getting really pissed off, and somebody else had rented it in the meantime.
What is this?
It's pinball,
dude. This is. Oh my god! What am I even looking at here? This is ridiculous.
What system was this for?
This is the 8-bit Nintendo.
Yeah, I've definitely never seen this. I'm not sure I've ever heard of this game.
All right, we busted up the grave, and now that dude's hanging out. Let's see if we can hit him.
Is he angry at you?
I don't think so.
He's just a friendly ghost. What do you want to mess with him for? What do you call that?
The plunger.
A friendly ghost?
What specifically when you hit the ball back into the lane where the plunger is?
You call it something that never happens on a real pinball machine because they put shit in place to prevent it, and it's dumb that it's so here at all.
There's no name for that. Is this... Wow. Tilt!
Come on!
This is a game basically the predator, the precursor to Yutsaido's Odama?
Yeah, pretty much. Look, you're really on the ball! this ghost needs our help to save the princess who's been kidnapped, is being held captive further north. Destroy the monsters that get in your way and increase your attack strength. I am sorry I cannot give you any more help. I used to be a soldier in the king's army, but now I'm just a spirit walking the earth. Anyway, late.
Didn't know he was going to get all philosophical on me.
Ugh. Okay, so now that area has... That little gate has opened up.
Ah!
God damn it.
Jeez. Cool. Are they going to make you start over?
No.
Okay, good.
Thankfully, I mean, you know, they give you... There's kind of a gimme here at the beginning. God damn it.
Yeah, I was going to ask, like...
The physics in this suck.
Yeah, they don't look entirely great. I have a question from the chat from Mecha Godzilla. There's a game I've been trying to find for a long time for the NES. All I remember is that you are a cool dude, circle with sunglasses, and you have to get gems. It was a puzzle type game. I have no idea what that is.
Super Squeak? No, that's
a trick question.
Possibly.
Wait, what? Can you read that description? You're a cool dude.
You're a cool dude, circle with sunglasses, and you have to get gems. It was a puzzle type game. Oh, geez. Are those alien skeletons?
Wait, they actually make you play the previous level again?
Yeah, if you fall down, you have to get back up.
This is ridiculous.
So the other thing is I have to push up and down to move the flippers.
Weird.
They don't render multiple sets of flippers.
This is so crazy.
It's
terrible. Jeez.
Man.
That is a weird visual effect. And they respawn, too.
Not really digging these alien skeletons so much.
Fucking hell.
Cool spot, the 7-Up game, maybe?
I was going to say.
That was a Genesis game.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I Ate Donuts wants to know, what is the best pinball video game that isn't based on real tables?
I'm going to say Crew Ball, just because, hey, they made a pinball. There you go.
Oh, jeez.
What is the objective here?
So sometimes I'll kill enemies and earn currency, and there are shops and shit.
See what you mean about the physics.
Yeah, they look terrible.
The ball movement is questionable
it's
at best.
Awful. It's awful. Oh, God.
Can you blow up the trees?
No, they're just bumpers.
Oh, jeez.
Is this better or worse than the NES game Pinball?
Is there really an NES game that's just called Pinball?
Yep. There is an NES game called everything, like ice hockey.
That's fair.
Football. I don't think there was ever one just called football, but I could be wrong.
No, they had 10-yard fight.
I was just about to say, there's 10-yard fight. That's it.
Blades of Steel.
Which is a fucking great name for a football game.
Uh-oh.
Jeez. Oh, you made him.
So I think he'll attack my... Or some of these guys can attack your flippers and make it so you can't flip, which is a pretty screwed up thing to do.
That would probably make it pretty hard to play pinball.
Pray defeated.
All right, I've got two attack dots. I've leveled up, I guess. But I think you lose that if you lose your ball, so...
Something shifty about that bush.
I got the key. I open the door.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, geez. He's just leaving. He's just fucking him out. Great. So we can go over to the store here.
Try stealing something.
You can buy better flippers. So if I've done this right, yes, everything costs 0 gold, apparently. So
how do you steal stuff? Does it just like give you an option for?
I forget how that works. Uh-oh. I think I got caught stealing.
I like the icon for this, just a little smiley face.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, something rude was happening there.
I got it. I stole stuff.
You skipped.
Can I have the devil flippers, which this is, you're not supposed to have those until later in the game, so I'll be doing way more damage, I think.
Is this supposed to be in black and white?
Yeah, I think it's just, you know, it's a castle. Eat it, wizard.
You like pinball, don't you, Jeff?
I do like pinball.
Yeah.
It's,
tougher to find now, but it's still around. Oh, that sucks.
You know, I would say the pinball industry is way more vibrant than the arcade industry at this point.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Well, it has some new challengers. It's not just Williams anymore. That new people. I know.
Yeah, what's that other company called?
Strong? Jersey Jack and Stern are the two companies that are making stuff these days. Okay, so I think I've got everything I can get here. Oh, maybe I have to... Maybe that's just inventory and I actually have to use the item. So for failing there, guess what?
Hey!
It drags me back down here, and the ball flickers sucks and bounces all the way back down.
Through the walls.
Wow,
and here we are.
Yeah, this game's fucked.
Oh, wow. You even have to do all the graves and stuff again.
This game's fucked. Now you see why I'd ran it multiple times and never truly got anywhere.
Yeah.
But what a cool idea, huh?
It is very cool, for sure.
Well, it's interesting now because there are so many game genres that have been RPGized to like Call of Duty and everything with experience points and bars like that. It's kind of a progenitor of that whole thing. I think RPG experience systems can be applied anywhere.
Yep.
And this game is proof.
I think a lot of game designers agree with you.
Even football games now have career modes and shit like that.
The crazy thing about this for me is like pinball... flippers and ball and rules, and then here's just like grass and trees and enemies.
Yeah, yeah.
Like this is not in any way like a facsimile of a pinball table. It's just like action game.
Yeah, I thought I always thought that was a cool thing.
Yeah, that's the weird mashup here to me.
Okay, I actually activated the devil flippers.
I was gonna say they didn't change before.
Oh jeez. So
wow,
is that a tiny helicopter in there? What is that?
These physics are amazing.
No, fuck.
Oh.
Fuck Pinball Quest. I remember really liking this game, but Jesus.
The ball looks really sad.
He's not the only one.
Wow.
Alright.
Uh-oh. So it had three other tables as well. Let's just quickly. Weirdly enough, even though these are more, these are closer to real pinball table style, it still has you move the flippers up and down. Just bizarre.
What the hell? They're making a movie about Grand Theft Auto, but not a game adaptation. They're making it about Rockstar Games.
Wait.
That is so weird.
So was it a documentary?
No, it's Game Changer. It's about the Jack Thompson stuff.
Oh, it's dramatized.
Yeah, dramatized. Oh, weird. It's got like Daniel Radcliffe in it.
Who's he playing?
He's gonna be Sam Houser.
What?
It's so weird.
What? Who's making?
BBC is making a movie about Rockstar.
Yeah, the BBC Two is making. Yeah.
That is so weird.
Totally. I mean, you know, like that's. That's nothing if not super fucking interesting and insane. You know? Like,
whose version are they going to film?
Well, aren't the Rockstar people usually pretty press shy? They don't really talk a huge amount?
I don't know.
Or they do it pretty sparingly.
It's pretty sparingly. It kind of depends on the situation, I think.
Like, they definitely talk when they want to talk.
I'm sure Jack Thompson will talk.
Yeah, you know, I'd say the Housers, the shy away from press.
Yeah, it's very much like, you know, the credit goes to Rockstar Games on a lot of stuff, you know, awards and things like that, instead of necessarily like a person.
Right, but I don't get the sense that they're afraid to talk to the press. It's more like we'll talk when we feel like it.
Oh, yeah, they definitely have so much success. They kind of don't need they could have not said anything to anybody about GTA 5 and it still would have sold 10 million copies. They're kind of like Blizzard in that sense, but Blizzard has pretty good PR. But they don't entirely need to, be enthusiastic about it, I guess.
Yeah. These other tables are nothing to write home about.
Yeah,
like,
I was gonna
RPG mode is kind of the thing, and these are just like, eh.
Yeah, it's funny how that mode is at the bottom of the menu, but that's like the only reason to play the game. Well, arguably.
But they didn't name it Pinball Quest, so at least it seems like they at least understood that that was the core of it. And it's not just like, Pinball Party, plus there's an RPG mode, I don't know.
Except the part where it seems impossible to play.
Well, there's that, but you know. You're making an 8-bit NES fucking pinball game. Naturally, it's gonna be janky and fucked up. Anyway, that's Pinball Quest.
All right.
Brad, I'm gonna pass this up here to you.
Man, I've started to dread this moment.
No pressure.
And we'll get our next game going.
All right.
You requested this one. This is.
Yeah.
I asked you if you wanted to play more Holy Diver, and you said maybe some other time, because instead you want to see this rare video game.
Early. Yes, it's exceedingly rare, for sure.
Wizards and Warriors. Published, rare developed.
Yeah.
Wizards and Warriors.
It's got the stamp of the stampers on it, I guess, right?
Yeah, I would assume so. This is a weird fucking game.
Yeah, so I never owned this. I think I played it at somebody else's house.
Oh, I beat this once. It's a really long time ago.
That's one of the weird things I remember about it, right off the bat. Like, the walk animation just locks in place. You can just step through it frame by frame.
I could have sworn you played this on a UPF. Like,
that's weird.
We messed with it, like, super briefly. Yeah,
you and Jeff did.
At the end of last year, yeah.
Oh, okay, during
that big monster. Can I go down? Is that a door I just went in?
Why? Yeah, that's a door. You just went in a door. The door opens and closes on a cycle, so you have to jump in it when it's open.
Is it?
But maybe you want to be in here, I don't know.
I just remember the attack animation being so limited range. Okay, it was almost,
you don't have the key.
Yeah, I'm just like, what am I doing?
So it's colored keys. It's you need gems to open the way to the next level.
Oh, that was another weird thing. Like, your sword is active as an attack item even if you're not swinging it. Like, just
So when you're jumping, you can attack stuff that way. Well, also, you have infinite health.
Yeah, that's a good thing to have here for sure. What is that thing?
You need an item to open those.
A nut.
Yeah,
I remember this tree music is great. Best tree music on the NES. So should I just get out of here?
Well, I mean, you could probably go up too.
Yeah, this was famous for having Fabio on the cover of the second version of this,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, Iron Sword.
According to chat.
I should go back in there. I don't know if I can go down or not.
Okay. Yeah, you can.
I can go down. Oh, these eagles. Real assholes.
Yeah. This is kind of really.
Like, the swing animation is crazy. Like, there's a little range on it.
Yeah.
It just, like, looks crazy.
Also, like, this is just me hitting X. Like, he's occasionally doing different moves with it.
Yeah.
When I'm not changing anything.
Yeah, like you're hitting, like, the equivalent of B, I guess,
right? Right, but sometimes he attacks up, sometimes he attacks in front of him. Like, also, I'm trying to kill this.
Just jump on him.
All right. And you need the gems, right? Like, isn't that how they gate progress?
You exit the level by getting 100 gems, I believe. And there's a hot key.
Key?
Also, like, look at the perspective on this, like, the concept of these tree stumps that you're, like, jumping on and, like, what... There's no depth. The perspective is super weird, you know?
This is a strange time.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I just jumped into that guy and he died. What is that?
Yeah,
clock.
Freezes everything. For, like, 5 seconds.
Wow, yeah, that was very helpful. Thanks, game. I guess I should go in the blue door since I got the blue key.
Is this based on a license, or was it...
I don't believe so.
No.
So this takes place in the Forest of Elrond, I read.
Sure, of course.
Which is like, yeah, okay. Let's just start mining fantasy tropes and terms wholesale.
It was a simpler time.
I guess, yes. That's for sure.
Just jump straight up. I think you could have reached...
Maybe the jump is higher than I'm realizing. I need pink key.
Part of the game that the guy was asking about before was Dudes with Attitude.
Mm.
They're in Rad Hot City. I don't know if this looks familiar at all.
Rad Hot City.
Yeah, I want to live there.
Oh. It sounds like you need air conditioning.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Sucks. Yep. Man, I'm glad I got infinite health here.
Like, that to me is this game. It is fucking up a jump, falling a bunch, and going, man, fuck this.
Pretty much.
Well, there apparently was a Wizards and Warriors TV series.
Fucking hell. I'm just going to go.
You are.
I'm just going all the way.
Oh, it was made by Rare. Holy shit.
Yep.
I could have sworn this was a Japanese game originally.
Nope. Spiders just don't quit.
The bad guy in this is called Malkill.
That's pretty good.
I mean, he's a pretty bad guy.
Yeah, that's fair.
Ooh. The name says it all.
This is getting nerve-wracking. I don't want to be up here. Oh, that looks useful. Oh. Hey, it's the pink key. God damn it.
I fall all the way down. We'll all laugh.
God damn it, I'm afraid to take that step.
You can step.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'm really terrified that there's like a gap between here and that nest.
Okay. Chef, can you explain why the player character apparently blinks out of existence from time to time? Is that a V-Sync issue or is that a
what?
Emulation issue or?
Games would flicker.
Yeah.
If people aren't seeing it at home, it's because the frame rate of the action is not matching. So this is the end of the level. You need 100 gems there.
There's that dude. You like, yeah.
So go get that open chest.
Am I?
No, go get...
God,
oh,
damn
my
it.
God.
I don't want to go back up there.
You have to go back inside. Well, get that chest while you're here. There are important items in some of those chests.
Okay.
You will definitely want.
Oh, I remember this music now. Fairly rude. Am I gonna just have to run up that tree again?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah, you are.
Is there anything else around here that I might need? Nope. There's three keys though, right?
Per level? Maybe this level may only have two. Okay. It might be good.
Yeah, there is a space between the two keys there for another key. Oh, that really is the only door, isn't
there? There's that other door that you came out of at the beginning that you can go in and there's stuff in there. But hey, you should get that chest.
God damn it. Sometimes I want to not go through the door.
You should get that chest.
Why?
Because it's got items in it that will help you.
Like what?
Like a sick knife.
Like this? Which door are you talking about?
The one that you were just in, the blue door that
I thought you said a different door.
No, I think you'll eventually need to go in that gray door too, because I think there's an item down there. But some of these chests have
I thought you were talking
more
about
than just gems.
I thought you meant a different door than this one here.
Okay, you got that one. So I'd go back in the gray door, because I think that might be where the knives are.
It wouldn't want to go in there.
It opens on a cycle.
I refuse to believe that hast was ever a real word that anybody used.
What?
Hast? Thou hast discovered gems? I don't think that's
red.
If you just stand there, it'll open.
It's quad damage.
And then jump in.
This game kind of sucks. I remember playing it and liking it at the time, but...
Yeah, maybe you're right.
I remember it being really difficult, and there was a lot of fucking falling down bullshit, too.
Yes.
I think, like, the thing we were looking at before the show, like, the wiki page makes it sound like it was pretty lenient on continues. I do remember finishing this game.
Yeah, I do really. It's like being the ultimate hero of the ages, having to go defeat the wizard Malkil, and then you just wind up jumping around trees for the first half hour of your adventure. I recall the rest of the levels. Wow, I really hit a high pitch there. I recall the rest of the levels being fairly vertical as well, right?
I think you're right. I think that's the bulk of the game.
Maybe we'll find out soon.
You want that chest.
Oh, shit.
Boots of Force.
What's that do for me?
I think it means you kill stuff when you land on it and you get a little bounce, maybe. There.
Oh, I remember this upstairs level, too.
I don't know that you...
I didn't get there yet. Gotta get the screw attack.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen, is it?
Well, you can jump over and it'll be like you went up the other tree.
Wait, say that again?
Just jump into that blue door. And then jump back out and you'll be up there where the end of the level is.
Jeff, what is the purpose of the evil gauge? Do you know?
The evil what now?
The evil meter there.
Oh, that's when you're fighting a boss.
Oh. That makes no sense at all.
You need the knife to get that. There's another chest that has a knife in it, but I think you might as well just go forward. All right. You have enough gems to leave.
Okay. Where is that guy again?
He's up and to the right.
Just over here.
Some people are curious if
that chest there is probably the knife. But I think you would have to fall down again to do it. So you see he's out of your way now.
Why is he just standing there guarding a tree rather than going after the evil wizard Malkil? If he's making sure that
people are tough enough.
Yeah.
He knows he's not tough enough for the final battle, but
should just go, right?
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah, might as well.
There you go.
Okay. That'll work.
How's this work? Oh, shit.
Yeah, it collects items. It's fucking great.
Do you have that for the rest of the game?
I think you'll have it until you die, but you shouldn't die. So maybe you might reset at the end of the level, so.
Oh, shit. Wow. Down here in the root system now. I remember this.
Yeah.
I'm sliding off the.
There's a red chest up there. You don't have a red key.
Maybe there. I guess there is a red key on this level. It's good to know that being completely inscrutable was not just the domain of Japanese games back then.
Here is a Western
developed game that still makes no sense.
Dude, like, there are plenty of Commodore 64 games and a lot of other stuff out there that just make no motherfucking sense.
Makes you wonder if the people making games back then were all on drugs or something.
I think it was just like they had a specific vision in mind, and, you know, unless you read the, you know, if they wrote... A lot of stuff didn't make it into the game, so unless you were reading their directions...
Oh!
Yeah. Evil! So now there's evil on the meter.
I remember this guy very specifically.
I'm gonna exercise my brilliant Wizards and Warriors technique.
Good stuff.
Get all that treasure and then go!
Nice work.
You remember how hard this was? Like, was it one life per hit, generally?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm gonna actually have to turn off the cheats here because it's trying to count down your life.
Oh wow. Okay. So the score would just go forever?
Yeah, basically. Let's see here.
See how long it can go for? You hear about that Bloodborne?
Yeah,
easy
I've heard
mode?
About it.
No.
Easy mode thing?
Yes.
Apparently, if you turn off your PS4 suspend mode and leave Bloodborne on overnight, all the bosses become really easy.
What?
Like, they just...
It somehow is not able to implement, like, subsequent attack patterns on the bosses.
It's either a bug or a really weird easy mode.
You got me.
Like a weird memory leak or something?
I don't think it's a... Like, usually with a memory leak, software just, like, it crashes or gets insanely slow or something. Yeah. Like, it doesn't function right.
Yeah, I was watching some before and after videos.
So you just leave the system on overnight?
Yeah, leave the game running.
People are saying 12 hours, but that's probably just a ballpark. But yeah, like, if you leave the game on for a very long period of time, a lot of the bosses won't go into, like, second and third forms.
So there's one that has, like, this big three sweep attack, and I watched a video, and after that, all he did was just, like, swing once, and then pause and wait, and then swing once again, and he looked like he was so much easier to beat.
I should really pay attention to my health here.
I turned off the cheat here, so you're taking damage. Mostly, I just want to hear the music that plays when you get low life.
Well,
assuming it's the same on every level.
A few people asking about Mortal Kombat X. Mortal Kombat X coverage plans. We assume.
We'll do some stuff next week.
Yeah.
We might do a live stream. I don't know. We're thinking about it.
Cool.
and we'll talk about it on the podcast.
People seem interested in the game. I've seen a few of those fatality videos that before whoever took them all down.
God damn it.
Those look pretty brutal.
Yeah, I guess like there are some copies that got out in Europe or something. We're not sure who has it, who doesn't. Like that, I'm not too clear on that, but it seems like some copies got out there. Hello. This guy's just hanging out, practicing his shit.
Oh no, they're mercenaries, aren't they? They're waiting for you to give them 100.
They want you to have them. Okay, but they don't actually take the gems from you.
Well, they're charitable mercenaries.
They just want to make sure that you can get it.
Yeah.
Hey, we just want to make sure that you can like you're good for it.
They're basically checking your credit.
They're gonna pop out as soon as I jump over there. You're fairly generous with the health items. Where do I go
just
here?
Jump hard to the left and.
I mean that I can't. Okay, there we go. A lot of these slopes are too sloped. And you just slide.
You don't have a red key.
Yeah, I need a key. Fuck you.
Wait, what kind of cave is this with fire just coming out of mouths on the side of it?
I don't know, but
it's a fucked up cave.
Yeah.
I was hoping that would get health out of that. Oh god.
Yeah, that's annoying.
Dude. There.
Yeah, this game. Can you just keep walking to the left? Yeah, this is it.
Shit. This is annoying. It's about to go really badly.
Do you want me to turn cheese back on? Pause it and I can do it. All right. All right. So I guess like each level just becomes like a key hunt.
Yeah.
Apparently you get the select button to kick open chests when you have the boots of force.
Wow.
Oh.
Wow, okay. That's good enough.
Find a chest, maybe you can try kicking it.
Oh!
That's cool. Shit, I don't think I ever knew that.
Yeah.
Alternate win method.
I'm kind of bummed I got that key.
Go get that chest, man. Maybe there's another cool shit in there.
I want to find a chest to kick.
Damn
it. I want to find a chest to kick open. Gems. I don't remember seeing chests of other colors in this level.
Yeah, I feel like they were all red, weren't they? There's that red door down at the bottom.
Maybe
just go in there.
I don't see anything good.
There's one.
Okay.
Fucking boot that thing open.
Yeah. All right. Man.
Game changer.
How does that potion work?
You like double tap jump or something? Or
can you use it? Is it a usable item?
Oh, that was another weird thing about this game. If you hold down jump, he'll just keep jumping.
Great.
Yeah, I don't know how to use
it. Up and jump, maybe? There you go.
Oh, right. Can I do that midair? Nope. I'm not sure how useful that is if you can't do it in midair.
Well, you get a little more height out of your jump, right?
No. I mean, like, I literally can only do it from standing.
Yeah, but you can jump at the end of it, right?
Oh, you can. Okay, you're right.
I was about to say, I don't know about this game, but I think I know about this game. But I remember this being like beloved in a way. Like people were like, oh yeah, Wizards and Warriors, it's classic. Like at the time even, people were like into Wizards and Warriors.
You look like you double jumped there in some weird way.
Mm.
Oh, geez. Is that what the potion does?
Yeah.
God damn it, I keep hitting the ceiling. I can't quite make that jump. This is not happening.
Success again?
Yeah. Whoa, that was weird. Yeah, I can't quite. There.
fuck everything.
Go all the way down to the bottom where that red door was.
Yeah.
I like that it had a "you're falling too far"
animation.
Like, oh shit. I always thought that was kind of cool.
Still nothing happens.
Boot that fucking chest open. Fuck yeah. You got enough gems to leave now.
Is it 100?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh,
that
shit.
One too.
Boom.
Shit.
Sure. I wonder if they just didn't bother even putting the other keys on this level.
Yeah, well, I just figured, like, if you have the boots, you can get all this bonus stuff, but otherwise it's just the red stuff.
Otherwise, fuck you. Yeah, if those other keys are around, I'm not going to find them.
Yeah, just leave.
This part again.
I can see the next area, and I think I'm nearing my limit.
Yeah.
When it comes to Wizards and Warriors.
I'm pretty good.
This kind of reminds me of the time I spent like half an hour streaming Dark Souls. Couldn't hit a jump. I'm sure it was so annoying to watch.
This game's pretty much the original Dark Souls.
Yeah. I spent that specific...
No, I know.
God, I think I still have it on my YouTube channel. I just kept on trying to make this jump for like half an hour.
Let's just run.
So annoying.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, weird. Who could have expected that would have gone bad for you? Animation on those bats, pretty shitty.
Yeah, this is a pretty early NES game, right?
Yeah, I seem to remember it being first couple years.
Ghosts! I couldn't move for a second there. It's treasure.
All right. Oh, I'm gonna have to turn these cheats off again here. Okay. There we go. And you saved another lady. Congratulations.
Rescuing Maiden's Fair left
Esmeralda,
and right.
Esmeralda.
Okay.
The distressed damsel.
The map.
The map. The warrant.
Getting deep in the color palette here.
Horn!
Horn.
Okay. I
love that horn.
I'm trying to, yeah, I think we're kind of out of buttons though.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't have the kick anymore. Let's hit every button on this controller, but yeah, select is not kicking anymore. Ow, it's hot. Hey, I'm burning. Anybody?
I mean, I could turn the cheats back on, but you know what?
I'm actually surprised I lived through that if the cheats were off. A lot of NES games would just straight kill you there.
Yeah.
Yep,
oh, god damn it. I think it would affect the bubbles too. Nope.
Nope.
Nope. Hmm. I'm going for it.
Yep.
All right. Now where?
You gotta go back to the purple door!
Oh god, is that where it was?
Yeah!
I was thinking there was some stuff
you were
over
just there.
Here.
Hey.
Oh wow,
yeah,
you
did. Didn't seem like there's enough stuff here.
Yeah, I knew there was something down here. It's actually like shockingly generous with stuff on the lava.
You gotta
that bubble. Get all those bubbles.
I think it, doesn't that go right under that ledge though?
Oh, maybe you're right. But maybe you're wrong.
It's very possible.
A lot of game requests of this series, Jeff. How should people communicate this to you? Maybe just make a thread on the forum somewhere?
Yeah, yeah. Start a thread on the boards. People have requests.
All right, I'm going to test
someone requested Shakan the Forever Man, which... Boy, that game.
Oh, weird. It just takes you through the wall if you're on the bubble.
I like this little beat here.
Yeah.
Music's all right. Man, I'm really missing those boots now.
Front of the horn will detect secret areas.
How do you use it, though?
I'm assuming
it's probably
select.
The same button as the... Yeah.
You'd think it would have some
boots,
kind of...
Right?
Ah, well, I'm a baby!
I don't know,
I'm a dead baby!
I don't know, I hit select and nothing happened.
Maybe it only plays if there's actually a secret area
maybe it's
there
just
or
passive.
Something like that.
Whoop.
Yeep!
Brad, I think we might have reached our limit for Wizards and Warriors.
That's fun.
What do you think?
I remember... Everything I need to remember now about this game.
Yeah. Well, what's your take on it now?
That's all right. I mean, the controls are pretty stiff, but
it's like the inventory stuff's kind of an interesting. Yeah. Like it's not just a standard action game.
Yeah, totally.
It's mostly a standard action game, but
a little more to it.
Nintendo Power voted Wizards and Warriors the best game to use with the NES Advantage controller.
What?
Remember they put in turbo buttons on official controllers?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are there like any third-party controllers that actually have turbo buttons anymore?
Yeah, totally. I guess so, yeah.
I wasn't sure that'd be something that console makers would frown upon.
Going all the way down. No, I'm not.
No, yeah, people make all kinds of weird stuff, but it's not, they're not licensed in a lot of cases. Yeah. You know?
Like those Call of Duty ones with the,
right,
the
weird
triggers
back
go halfway down.
And all that stuff. I only need 50 gems here.
Oh, we're so close.
But not close enough. Aww. Brad, that's going to do it.
All right.
For Wizards and Warriors, a game that I don't think is any good.
Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of interesting, but yes.
Somebody asked how lava forms bubbles, and that's a pretty good question.
A lava bubbles up. They're just extrapolating that to mean the bubbles then rise out of the lava, which they sure wouldn't do, but look, man, look.
All right.
All right.
There you have it.
There you have it. Thanks, everybody, for coming and hanging out. Wizards and Warriors, man, I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, no, like I said, I do know.
You,
that
you know,
doesn't
yeah
seem like a very good game. Sadly, still not getting to play Valis 3, but someday.
Yeah.
We hold out hope. Maybe someday we'll get to play Valis 3.
What if all the choices were Valis 3?
Well, maybe. We'll see next time. And until next time, thanks everybody for watching. We'll see you soon.